Praise the Lord. It is indeed such a blessing and an honor to be alive today. This morning, our topic is Don't Look Back. Almighty God, we thank you for this day. We bless your name and we magnify your day or your name. Father, have your way this morning. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you glory, honor, and praise. Mighty God, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. Mighty God, you are my strength and you are my redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen. As I said before, our topic this morning is don't look back. When life becomes challenging, if you have failed several times, if you have messed up a perfect relationship, and if you are bored of your job, your house, your friends, and family, a new start sounds really exciting. Though many believers know this truth, that a new start is possible, they still tend to live beneath this truth because the lies of the old life seem to capture their souls. The fact is, the enemy of our souls knows that if he can keep us looking back, we will make little progress in the future God has for us. We all have a past, and for some, it may be memorable. For others, it may be horrible. But whatever the past looks like, the enemy tries to keep us in the what was or what used to be state. But we serve a God that loves to plan ahead of us. His children, and the scripture tells us that his plans are always good in the end. Jeremiah 29 verse 11 reminds us this morning. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. This morning, I am not talking about literally turning your heads and looking back, but looking back as a heart condition. The Bible talks about our heart following our treasure. Luke 12, verse 34. Looking back and living in the past constantly dictates that you believe your treasures are still buried there. We know the story of Lot's wife and how her heart was so caught up in the treasures of this world, so much so she could not see the grand future God had planned out for her. I am sure many of you have heard of the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah and the destruction of fire and brimstone that rained down and ruined them. Lot's wife lived there with her family. And though it was a place of much immorality and disgraces, her heart was very much tied to it. But children of God, because of the prayers of Abraham, God would save Lot and his family from devastation. God allowed them enough time to escape with instruction. Genesis 19, verse 17. Do not look behind you, nor stay anywhere in the plain. Family and friends, don't pick up what God has overthrown. When God burns up and overthrows a thing, whether it is an opportunity, whether it is a business, whether it may be land, maybe a job, maybe a relationship, or anything else that God has told you not to touch, don't self-select the parts that you think are good or seemingly salvageable. Remember Saul in 1 Samuel chapter 15? God commanded Saul to utterly destroy the Amalekites and to kill everything, not some things. God told Saul to kill everything. What has God told you to kill? You cannot take this in the next season with you. Pass the king's test of obedience today. When God gives a command, he tests the character of your heart to see if you will follow him or adhere to the voice of the people. Don't follow popular belief. Submit to God's instruction. Kill everything God says you are to kill. Don't hold on to what you think is right. Saul failed the test. He held on to what he thought was valuable. What do you value most? God's instructions or the opinions of people? It's your choice to choose to follow God's word for your life, or you can fall into destiny destruction by listening to the opinions of people. Follow God with your whole heart. Overthrow the things that he's overthrown in your life. Don't carry extra weight. Don't carry dead weight. Don't carry dead baggage. Don't carry them with you into the next season. God wants you to let go of the past and release your faith for the future. His future for you is bright. You must take your next step forward in faith, knowing that God has your steps ordered when you follow his instruction. God has not given you an assignment that you cannot handle. God will connect you to the right people, those after his heart, those who are for you, those who are sent and set by God to handle your season with you. God wants his best for you. Don't look back. Don't pick up what God has told you not to touch. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Don't look back. Move forward. Looking back is disobedience, and disobedience will keep you stagnant. The heart of Lot's wife was stuck in Sodom. Although her physical body was moving forward, her heart was stunted in the past. You can't take a broken heart into a new season. Lot's family was moving forward into another season, and they had to leave the stagnant place behind. They also had to leave Lot, and she became a pillar of salt, a manifested reflection of her heart. She was stuck in the place of her disobedience. Genesis 19:26 says, but his wife looked back behind him, and she became a pillar of salt. Family, when you focus on the past, your heart becomes stunted at a place of your offense. When you disobey God, your destiny becomes stuck at the point of your disobedience. Forgive and be set free. Obey God and walk forward in freedom. Walk forward in deliverance. Walk forward in prosperity. When you decide to turn back to your former lusts, you decide to idolize the past and exalt the former things over God's word. When you worship these things over God's command, your worship to God becomes stunted and muffled. What other idols are you magnifying over God? Do you find it hard to worship God freely? Maybe you've magnified the pains of the past, and it's become hard for you to even lift up your hands and worship God. Maybe you've held on to past offenses, and your heart has become stiff, and it's hard to focus on worshiping God. Just maybe you have grown bitter in some areas, and parts of your heart have turned into pillars of salt. Maybe there are parts of your heart where you refuse to love again, to heal again, or to open up again. Some of you, you're saying, oh, I would never marry again. I would never love again. No, God has called us to love. Moving forward, focus on him, worship him, and allow God to heal your heart completely. He has assured us in his word in Isaiah 42, verse 8 to 10. I am the Lord. That is my name, and my glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images. Behold, behold, the former things are come to pass, and new things do I declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you of them. Sing unto the Lord a new song, and his praise from the end of the earth. You that go down into the sea, and all that there is therein, the isles and the inhabitants thereof. A new start is available to you, no matter where you've been or what you have done. Jesus Christ died to save and to give you a brand new start. Jesus specializes in new beginnings, new mercies each morning, new grace. Hallelujah, Jesus. And now, even in my own personal life, I look at every disappointment, every hurt, and every pain as an opportunity to give birth to something new. We do ourselves great injustice, and we lock God out. And we keep looking back negatively, we are made to move forward, and it's time to stop looking back. Isaiah 43 verse 19 tells us, behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will even make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. There are new God-given opportunities. God has orchestrated assignments and God-given relationships set on your path when you obey and follow Christ. Follow his word. Follow his instruction. Choose not to magnify the pain. Don't magnify the past. Don't magnify the mistakes of the past. Be intentional in your choice to be led by God. He has a new future in store for you. No matter how old you are, no matter how far into sin you are never too old or too young to repent and to follow God. You are never too far out of his reach. You are never too unreachable. God will reach you, teach you, and lead you in every season. Don't turn back to your old way of doing things. Seek God and let him lead your path. Looking back provides a false sense of security. There's some people that are in abusive relationship, and they would rather stay there because they feel that they are more secure in that than stepping out in faith into the unknown. Don't look back onto those false sense of security. Even if you're in a wilderness and it appears that there is no way out, God will create a new path of deliverance for your escape. God will bring you out of your circumstance with a mighty hand. Even if he has to create a new way. There's no place too dark where his light cannot shine. There's no valley too deep that his love and power cannot bring you out. Let God do the new thing in your life. It's time to move forward. Let the past go. Don't carry the bondage of the past into the future that God has for you. Reach for the new thing. God has so much in store for you. A life of purpose, a life of passion, and a life of power. Brethren, do not count yourself to have apprehended. But one thing that you must do is to forget those things which are behind. And you must press forward toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. The children of Israel could not rid themselves of looking back. They had that looking back mentality. They saw giants in the land rather than the big, big God with them. Living in the past is a great detriment to your future. Don't look back. Leave the past behind. Clear your heart of the clutter and take hold of your glorious future that God has planned for you. The past is over. God is about moving forward. Don't look back. Almighty God, I thank you for your word this morning. Lord, we thank you that you have this bright future ahead of us. And so, mighty God, I say thank you, Lord God. And Father, for those who have been looking back, that has that looking back mentality, looking back with bitterness, anger, and refuse to let go. Mighty God, this morning, strengthen them in a very special and mighty way. Lord, continue to have your divine way in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen.